I received an email from a SmartThings staff member announcing the end of the SmartThings Groovy IDE interface. The Groovy IDE will be terminated effective September 30th, 2022. Quoting from the email, on September 30th, 2022, Groovy device DTHs, smart apps built on Groovy, and the legacy developer IDE will be removed from the SmartThings platform and will no longer be supported. This means that devices and automations previously using Groovy will now exclusively operate on our latest hub and cloud technology, end quote. Now continuing to quote, recognizing trends within the SmartThings industry, SmartThings has been working diligently to involve our platform into a modern REST API framework. Lua-based edge drivers are a major step, which is being followed quickly with the launch of the Matter protocol, providing a greater focus on interoperability and local communication. All of this platform growth has increased reliability, decreased latency, and reduced the need for data transfer outside of the home environment, end quote. SmartThings states that the transition for most hub-connected devices will be seamless, as will their abilities, which will be supported through the edge drivers. As I announced in previous updates, the transition is well underway, and SmartThings expects to fully complete the transition over the next 1.5 months. If you have devices that are currently supported by custom device handlers, you are reminded that these custom Groovy capabilities will not be supported, and you are therefore urged to contact the community member who created the custom device handler. SmartThings has affirmed that some devices may not transition automatically and will need to be re-onboarded. They did not specify the specific devices that may be impacted, nor did they give reference to the quantity or percentage of devices that would need to be deleted and reinstalled. Also, devices which are no longer supported by their manufacturers on the legacy platform will not be transitioned or supported on the new platform. SmartThings did provide a link to the current list of available edge drivers. I will leave a link in the description below this video. Just reference the link, current edge driver list. SmartThings also affirmed that developers can now share drivers with specific users or groups by creating a driver channel and providing a URL to channel invitees. This eliminates the need to copy and paste code. Also in this email, the SmartThings team has confirmed that it is their intent to launch Matter this fall. For those of you who are unfamiliar with Matter, Matter is a smart home interoperability protocol. It was launched as a joint effort by a handful of the industry's biggest players. Over 170 companies are involved, with Apple, Samsung, Amazon, Google, and the Zigbee Alliance being the most prominent names. The goal of Matter is to ensure that smart home devices can work across different ecosystems. So as an example, with the introduction of Matter, an Amazon Echo Show display should work with a Google Nest doorbell, just as it currently works with Amazon's own Ring doorbells. I did a quick survey of my devices, and I found out that of the 66 devices which are currently in use in my smart home, 31 of those devices, or about 50% of them, have already been automatically migrated to edge drivers. An easy way to check which of your devices have been converted to an edge driver is to log into your SmartThings account and look within the My Devices tab to see which devices have the placeholder designation. These devices are already using the new edge architecture. So what is the demeanor on the SmartThings community forum regarding this change? I would characterize it as somewhat somber with a lot of concern and pessimism due to how quickly SmartThings is terminating the Groovy IDE. Briefly, here are a couple of notable items in the negative or minus column. There is concern that nearly all of the smart apps, such as Speaker Companion and Enhanced Auto Door Lock, are going to be eliminated on September 30th. As a result, any of the automations that you created with a smart app will need to be manually recreated in a routine. Two smart apps that are not being eliminated are the Smart Lighting and the Smart Weather smart apps. These apps will be migrated to the new Edge architecture and will be integrated into SmartThings routines. At this point, it looks like the developers will not be developing integration for WebCore or Action Tiles, so you should not look for any support in the new Edge environment for these apps. There are some items in the positive or plus column, It is confirmed that SharpTools will continue to work after the migration, and their rules engine looks to be the best and easiest option for complex automations. They now have an option to connect through the new API, and they said they're working on a migration plan of their own to move existing customers from the old to the new API. It is also confirmed that there will be a custom edge driver for the Harmony Bridge, which you will be able to use to integrate RF devices such as an air conditioner, a fan, or TV. It is also confirmed that Philips Hue integration will continue to work. And finally, there was confirmation that there will be edge driver support for the use of virtual switches in the edge environment. If you check out Brian's channel over at Automate Your Life, he has stated that he's received confirmation from a SmartThings developer that the team will have successfully converted 99.99% of the 100 million user base. Brian has a recent video in which he gives a great summary of the future of SmartThings following the end of Groovy IDE. I urge you to check it out. The conventional wisdom on the SmartThings community suggests that we should be patient and not jump into manually delete and reinstall devices. Rather, we should wait and let SmartThings migrate the devices to see which devices are left behind. Those currently using WebCore will need to begin to rewrite their automations using SmartThings routines. If using SmartThings is not adequate, you can check out the SharpTools rule engine to see if it gives you the additional features that you need. If you need some help in setting up SharpTools, there is a video that I created on that topic. Just check out the link above. The question of will SmartThings continue to dedicate resources to improve edge drivers beyond the termination of Groovy IDE? SmartThings has stated, and I quote, "As we continue to bring you more features and new tools and to move SmartThings forward to the Internet of Things space, we will always do what we can to ensure that any transition from legacy systems during this time will be as seamless as possible, and we will keep you informed on changes as they come," end quote. You can stay informed by checking platform updates in the SmartThings community and also on this channel. Hey, thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next episode. Keep automating, and God bless.